Hi, Techie Shishi here with a tutorial on capturing those 360-degree fashion frame videos on PC. So we're on XCal today for a very basic tutorial video. Everybody has XCal, or you know, one of the other two starter frames. XCal is kind of the poster boy. So we're going to go to the arsenal, and you see here I just have XCal and Ascana, and we're going to go to appearance. Okay, and I don't have anything equipped or anything set because I'm just sort of showing off how this is done. So normally when you do this, you'd actually have, you know, color set up and skin selected and attachments and stuff. I don't have any of that set because I'm just showing off how this works. Okay, so we're going to go over here. This is the Captura button. And we go into Captura. And you want to choose a scene. For this video, I'm going to choose the Cold Below scene because it happens to be a nice open scene that allows us to do really good 360-degree videos. I also highly recommend things like the Plains of Eidolon scene, the Lua Balcony scene, the War Within Choice scene. There's a couple more that are actually good for this, or Valis scene. So there's a number of scenes that work well for 360-degree videos. Some of them don't. Some of them are quite cramped and are sort of not great for this kind of thing. But you can work with most of them. Okay. So right now we're going to go into the Cold Below scene. This will take a moment to load. You'll notice that we're in here, and we've got a nice open space, okay? So, the first thing we do is we're going to toggle the free camera and pull back a little bit. And you see in the bottom right-hand corner, we've got that settings select highlighted. We've got this panel open, and one of the things we have is settings select highlighted. And we're going to hit the X button to select that. And we have this here. Okay, so first thing, make sure your depth of field is turned off for the moment. You may choose to turn it on, but for the moment, turn it off while we set things up. So if you scroll down here, we'll get to this in a moment. This is vital, but we want to set some other things first. First thing we do is light settings. You'll want to set this up the way you want it. For right now, I'm going to set scene lighting in such a way that I get the proper lighting on my character. You'll notice that this front lighting is especially bright on him, and I want to tune that down a little bit. So I want to turn some of that brightness down. There we go. That's a little bit better. So now you can actually see him pretty well. Okay. There's a little bit too much light on his head still. So we can turn that. I think that's the fill light. No. Is that the main light? Nope, not the main light. Is that still the scene lighting? That's the scene lighting. Okay, so let's turn the scene lighting down to about there. Yeah, you'll notice how it's almost all the way down. And then we can use fill lighting. Let's set this fill lighting to white. Normally when I'm doing these tutorial videos, I just set everything to white. You may choose to set these to actual useful colors because they actually come off better. But for tutorials, white is a good choice. Okay. And so that's a nice sort of well-lit thing there. None of this is strictly necessary, but if you're going to do this kind of thing, you want to be able to see your character well. This is the whole point of fashion. So let's set toggle advanced time here. We want to set this because we want, in this particular case, I personally choose to show off animations during this 360 video. I find it to be a perfect point in time to show off the animations and not just the actual pose or anything like that. I'd like to show the animation itself, and this is a great time to do it because we get to see a video of it. Now we come up here and we get look at character. Okay, so this will snap our camera to the character. And you'll notice that if I use my mouse or my keyboard, I no longer actually move around in the world, but rather constantly look at the character itself. Okay? And I can't use my mouse to move my viewpoint anymore. I'm just forced to look at the character. This is important. In a moment, we'll see why. The other thing we want to do is we want to set our field of view pretty tight and back up a decent bit. Let's set our field of view to about here. And this is going to control how fast or slow the actual 360 goes. And the reason for this is because it controls sort of where in... So the field of view controls the size of the camera's focal depth. Look that one up, kids. That's sort of outside the scope of this. But the short version is, if you have the field of view all the way out here, you can see a lot of stuff. If you have it zoomed, this is sort of a zoom function. It's not really, and it gets complicated to explain the difference. But if you have it set there, you can get nice and tight in on your character while still having your camera far away. And that means that when you do a rotation around your character, it takes a long time to do so, which means your video gets to be upwards around 30 seconds, which is about the right time to get a proper set of about 2 animations, which is about the right amount. It doesn't feel rushed, but it also doesn't feel too slow, too long. Okay, so we've got toggle advanced time turned on. Let's turn off this post-capture dialog, not that it matters. And so now we can go ahead and go back, and you'll see that advanced time is set to T, so let's hit T. Okay, and let's move around. So we can hit spacebar to go up and control to go down. Let's get the right height, and let's move forwards until we've got the character just about perfectly in the frame. Now, one thing you'll notice is that as you move around, this camera zooms out some. So you'll need to re-zoom in order to get the right setting every time you do a spin around your character. It's annoying, but it's sort of a natural consequence of this. So once you're ready to start this, you're going to hit the L button to turn off that panel. Now here comes the magic, because I haven't really said what we're using to capture this. Well, built into every Windows 10 computer is something called the Xbox Game Bar. So if you hit, if you hit the Windows G key, it brings up this. This is the Xbox Game Bar, and you'll see you may have other panels turned on. Right now I have them turned off because they've got some personal information over here. The two things that we're interested in at the moment are this gallery here, which contains your most recent shots. I was just taking stuff for the Mesa contest upcoming in 2 weeks. And this capture thing up here. So you can pin these up here if you want. But interestingly here, we have a record button. And you'll notice that it's bound to Win-Alt-R. Okay? So I'm going to close this again by Win-G. And I'm going to wait for the right moment for this to start. And you'll notice if I hold Shift and right, it starts moving around slowly. That's how you slow movement. And so I'm going to use a shift right motion. You can use shift left if you want to go the other way. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do a Win-Alt-R about now. And I'm going to start moving it like this. Okay? And this is getting a good slow movement. I'm getting those animations in. It's going to end up with about a 15-second video. If I want it to be longer, I can either keep going, or I can do multiple passes. Okay. In this case, I'm going to do about 2 passes in order to get a couple of animations. And then we'll go back and take a look at it again and see what we can do to make a longer video that's a single pass round. Okay? So, there we go. And then to stop that, you win Alt-R again. And you'll see that game clip recorded pop up. And if you win G again, if you give it a moment, it should pop up in this list here. It may take a moment. That takes a little bit of time to settle down. That did just capture a video and drop it into your system. So that's generally how you do these captures, and it's pretty easy to do on Windows. One of the things to pay attention to here that you might want to check out especially if you're doing multiple things at a time on your computer, is hit the settings button here and go to this capturing tab and check out the audio to record. And if you have it selected to game plus enabled mic, it will record your game and your microphone. You can also check it to record your game, your mic, all of your apps in your system. That'll record everything on your computer. Now, if you're watching Twitch streams in the background, it will record them too. YouTube in the background, it will record them too. Be aware that can potentially be a problem if you're intending to upload this to a fashion frame contest or put it up anywhere else. But if you're just recording for your own posterity, that's not much of a big deal. You can also set it to none to just disable all audio recording. There's also a number of other options here if you want to take a look at it. And I should be able to update this by doing that again. Nope, it hasn't popped up yet. It does take some time normally. But if I click this, it should pop this up. Yep, and you'll see that this new video is up here already. Okay, and then if we go back in here. Yep, and now that I visited the folder, it showed up here. And I can play this, and you can see that it plays. Turn off the audio because I don't really care to have it doubling up. And so you see we get that. Now, we can do this again. Whoops, we can do this again. And this time, let me hit L to turn this back on. There's two ways to extend this for longer. One, you can turn on slow motion. But I don't really like slow motion because it slows down the animations, and I like the animations to run at full speed. The other way we can do this is we can actually zoom out further. And the way we zoom out further is actually by zooming in further. I know it sounds contradictory. We zoom in further and we pull the camera back some. And in doing so, you'll notice that the camera itself is actually further back, but we're zoomed in further, and so it takes longer to go around. Now the difference here is a little bit minimal, but let's try this again, and let's turn advanced time on, and turn the panel off, and let's get to about there. Make sure that I have him entirely in the frame. And Win Alt R. There we go. And you'll notice we're moving just a little bit slower around the edge. And my video is a little bit shaky right now because I'm actually running two sets of recording applications on my computer. I'm running both OBS to record this video, and I'm running the DVR game capture, the Windows game bar to capture this. And so you'll notice that this video ends up being about 25 seconds in a single pass round. That's about what I like for a single video. And so I generally like to use that level of distance. So there you have it. That's how you run that. There's a lot of interesting, useful things you can do in Capture, and in the coming weeks to months, I'll upload some more Capture videos. If you like this kind of content, you can choose to subscribe to me, or just check back occasionally. Enjoy!